Hello friends, good evening. Welcome to PDF for Exams YouTube channel. This is day 40. We are learning environment, and in this video we will be learning about protected areas network in India. So before starting the video, we should know what protected area networks in India means. So we'll just bifurcate the term individually and we'll see the meaning, what actually it means, and we'll combine the terms and understand what actually this protected area network in India means. Fine. So we can see over here there are a few terms like protected area networks in India. So India is a country, we know very well. Area is the measurement of any land area, you can say. Now we are left with two terms, protected and network. Protected simply means keeping safe from harm or injury. Okay, so how do you feel protected, or where do you feel protected? If we talk about ourselves, the human species, we generally have our habitat as our houses. Our habitat is our home, our houses. And this home or house can be of any form. It can be a hut, it can be a flat, it can be a building, it can be a bungalow, so it can be anything. The important fact over here is that you should feel protected. Protected from whom? So there are certain things like temperature. In summer season you can't stay outside, in winter also you can't stay outside, in rainy season also you can't stay outside. So almost in every season we can't stay out of our places. So we get protected from these external things. Apart from this, there are certain animals, like wild animals, you need to be protected from them. And apart from these animals, there are a few humans also, like theft, dacoit. So you have to be protected from these things also. So similarly, animals, they also need protection. And where they will be protected? They will be protected in their habitat. And what is habitat of animals? Habitat of animals are forest. You can say the most of the animals live in forest area. And apart from this, there are a few aquatic animals which reside in water body, like lake, you can say, rivers, oceans. So there are certain protected areas where all these animal species or plant species stay. And the next term over here which we need to understand is network. Network, you might be heard, or you might have heard about network in computers. In computers, network means a connection of something, zigzag connection, or any kind of connection of many computers you can call as a network. But if we understand a simple meaning of network, it means a group of system, a group or system, you can say, of interconnected people or thing. So any group or system which interconnect, the important fact term over here is interconnection of people or things, would be termed as network. So now we have the meaning of entire term, that is protected area network in India. So India, as we know, is a very huge country geographically. If you draw a rough map of India, let me draw a rough map, then I'll show you how, what we actually mean by this protected area network. Okay, so just a minute. So it's a rough diagram of India. Okay, so now we can see protected area. So there are certain protected areas. It might be placed somewhere in northern part, it might be there in western part of a country. Some protected area might be in southern part of a country, some protected area might be in eastern part of a country. So when these form a kind of network, you can say they are forming a network. So that's why they are called protected area networks in India. So this we mean by this. Okay, now we'll see some facts, and after that we'll try to know how many type of protected area are there in India, what are the significance, and what are and where are they actually located. Okay, so starting with the facts, the very first fact which is given over here is India is one of the 17 mega diverse countries in the world. Diverse means diversity. Diversity in what? Biodiversity. Since we are studying environment and biodiversity, environmental ecology, over here we are talking about biodiversity. Biodiversity means the different kind of species residing or staying on the earth, or you can say in water body. So there are 17 countries which consist of most of the diversity, biodiversity in entire world. In our complete world, our entire world, we have 190 plus countries, but out of those, only 17 countries consist of most of the species or most of the biodiversity, and India is one of those countries. Fine. Next is, India has only 2.4% of world land area. So this fact we have already seen in geography also, many times this fact has been rising. And India holds 16.7, or you can say almost 17% of world population. Now you can see the ratio over here. We only have 2.4% of land area, but the population that resides on this land area is around 16.7%. That means the population density in India is very huge. Why it is huge? Because if we compare the land area to the population, it varies a lot. Okay, And we have 18% of livestock, and which contribute to 8% of known global biodiversity. Now again, see, this is important factor in entire biodiversity. That means global biodiversity, which is present on our planet, India consists of 8% of known biodiversity. So there might be some species which are not known to human. It's not necessary that human will know each and every species which are present on Earth. See, species can be counted in plants, animals, microorganisms, birds, and it's not necessary that we know all the biodiversity. So that's why it is given over here that India contributes, or India has 8% of known global biodiversity. Okay. And see, again, an important fact. World largest wild tiger population is in India. It's not that only India has wild tigers, there are other countries which too has this wild tiger, but India is home for the largest wildlife tigers. That means India consists of the most number of wild tigers there in India. Okay. And apart from this, there is unique assemblage of global importance endangered species, and those endangered species are like Asiatic lion, Asiatic elephant, one-horned rhinoceros, Gangetic river dolphin, snow leopard, Kashmir stag, Dagong, Gharial, Great Indian Bustard, Lion-tailed Macaw, etc. So these are few endangered species. In previous videos, we have learned about these endangered species. Endangered species are the species which are at the verge of extinction, or the entire species might vanish from our Earth completely. That's why they are termed that endangered species, and there were certain steps taken to protect these species. And these protected area is one of those steps which are taken to conserve these species. Okay. Now we'll start with our topic, that is protected area network in India. So to form any network of, to form any protected area, what do we mean? Or sorry, what do we need? For example, to make your house where you live in, what did you need it? You needed some amount of money, some amount of planning, and there was someone to decide what kind of house you want to make, where you want to make your house, and that depended on your requirements. Like, if you were young at that age, or if you had to start your schooling, and your parents, if they were earning good, they would have tried to move into city area where you could get all the facilities and reside easily. So same case with this protected area network in India for animals and plant. Also, there is a board, that is National Board for Wildlife, which was required, and it is chaired by Prime Minister. That means Prime Minister is head of this National Board of Wildlife, and this board provides policy framework for wildlife conservation in the country. That means all the policies, all the framework, that means where these protected area would be made, how these protected area would be made, what would be the rules and regulation, what would be the laws which has to be followed in these areas, would be decided by this body that is called National Board of Wildlife, and it is headed by Prime Minister. I'm telling this again. Okay. And there was also a National Wildlife Action Plan which was adopted on 2002. And what was its emphasis? Its emphasis was support for wildlife conservation. So till now we have seen two bodies. One is National Board of Wildlife, and next is National Wildlife Action Plan. So it's not body actually. This is an action plan which was given by National Board of Wildlife. Okay. Now if we talk about the philosophy, that means on what basis India plans about its conservation of biodiversity. So it simply identifies the protecting representative wild habitat across all ecosystems. So as I said in the beginning, that habitat is very important for anyone to reside. So similarly, this habitat is being identified. For example, if some species are found to be endangered, if we take example of Royal Bengal tigers, so if they are found endangered, so their habitat would be found where they reside, or what kind of climatic condition, what kind of things they need to survive. So those are found and maintained. And this is the philosophy what India follows in conservation of biodiversity. So we have studied about Indian constitution in our polity. So even in constitution, in our concurrent list, what are these concurrent list? It was given in 7th schedule, which we have already discussed. So this concurrent list means the powers, or you can say the functions which state government and central government. So the functioning or the power are vested in these concurrent list. That means what function state has to do and what function center has to do. Since we have federal kind of government, these all we have discussed in polity, so I'm not going very deep over here. But still, for revision purpose, we should know that India has two kind of government. One is not two kind, it kind of federal kind of government. Federal kind of government means we have a government at central level, and we have government at state level or provincial level. Fine. And both has to work in coordination so that these protected area could be conserved. Why they have to work in coordination? Because we as human know geographical boundaries, but animal doesn't know any geographical boundaries. They can move from one place to another place. So this boundary, the state boundary could not be managed. So that they can be managed properly, for that very purpose, Indian government, this both central and state government has to work in coordination. Okay. Now there are few forest departments also meant. Why these forest departments are meant? So forest department is meant even in your UPSC, if you're giving for exam for UPSC, there is a different department, IFS, Indian Forest Services. So these services are meant for protecting all kind of biodiversity which are present in forest. Why it is required? Because what happened in most of the forest, illegal hunting, poaching, cutting off plants and trees, deforestation, you can say, these kind of activities are practiced. To stop these kind of activities, there has to be a certain department for this. This forest department was established, and there are 662 protected area which has been established in India in all, and if it extend all of almost 158,508 square kilometers, which is 4.83% of total geographical area of a country. Fine. And there are 104 national park, 551 wildlife sanctuaries, conservation reserve and community reserve. We'll discuss in detail what are these national park, what are these wildlife sanctuaries, and we'll also discuss about these conservation reserve and community reserves. Fine. Okay. And there are tiger reserves and elephant reserve which has been designated specific management, species specific management. That means there are certain reserves. What are reserves? Reserve generally means compiling, or you can say anything which is present in abundant in that place. For example, there are water reserves. So in water reserve, what we do, we store water even much more than what we need. So similarly, there are certain reserve where all there are few species specific, like if tiger is a species which is being on verge of extinction, so special attention would be given to this tiger in that particular area. So and like elephant, so elephant could be also one of species, so special attention would be given to certain species for conservation. Okay. And another important fact over here is given, UNESCO has designated 5 protected areas World Heritage Site. So out of these, what we had, 104 national park, 551 wildlife sanctuaries and few conservation reserve and community reserve, 5 protected area as termed as World Heritage Site by UNESCO. What is UNESCO? UNESCO is United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization. This is an international body which function at many levels, like in the full form you can see itself, like education, scientific and cultural organization. So these are the three areas where these this organization functions. So this organization also give title of World Heritage Site to many areas. Now what are these World Heritage Site? So World Heritage Site simply means outstanding universal value to humanity. So there are certain example, you can take example of Taj Mahal. So in India, so like this building is an universal value. It has got some value attached to humanity. That's why it is being termed as, or you can say it has given status of World Heritage Site. So like that, we have 5 protected area in a country which is being given status of World Heritage Site. Okay. And again, as ecosystem and species do not require recognized political boundaries, so which we have already discussed. So transboundary protected area has also been initiated between these bilateral, that means between the nations also. We have few land bordering countries like Bangladesh, Nepal, Bhutan, and in west we have got Pakistan, and some parts of Afghanistan also is land bordering country of India. So transboundary protection area has also been meant, because as we know, animals doesn't understand political boundaries or borders. Now there are four categories of protected area. Those are national park, wildlife sanctuaries, conservation reserves and community reserves. Okay, so we'll start with the very first kind, that is wildlife sanctuaries. So what are these wildlife sanctuaries? So we'll just read the definition and we'll try to understand what actually it means. So see, whatever protected area are there, there would be some common points in all kind of protected area. What are those common points? So those common points are like, these are meant to protect in some case some specific species, or most of the species, many species are being protected in that area. The another common point would be that it would be home of forest, water, valleys, rivers, all things would be present in these protected areas. Apart from these, it would be a scenic, a natural beauty. That means anyone who is interested to view nature with enclosed, so they can visit these places. So these would be common points in all wildlife sanctuary, or you can say all wildlife protected areas. So starting with wildlife sanctuary, Sanctuary is an area which comprise within any reserve forest or the territorial water. So any forest which are reserved, that means a boundary has been stated, not physical boundary, but it has been stated that like some board would be put up that this area belongs to a wildlife sanctuary, and all kind of illegal activity like certain rights of people would be also permitted. So like, there are, let's take an example, like there is a huge forest, okay. So in forest it's not necessary that only animals and plants live, some tribal people also stay in forest. So what happens due to this wildlife sanctuary, any forest area which has been given status of wildlife sanctuaries, rights of certain rights, I'm not talking about all the rights, we have our fundamental rights. So few rights of these people might be abandoned or they might be permitted. It depends upon the forest department, whoever is functioning over there. Okay. And what is the purpose of this sanctuary? So the purpose is protecting, propagating and developing wildlife or its environment. So again, this point will be common with all protected areas. Okay. And what else we have? Yes, and there is a chief wildlife warden who is responsible for every activity which is being going on there, that wildlife sanctuary. Okay, this is all about wildlife sanctuary. The next term is national park. So national park is an area which is there inside this sanctuary. So here we can see over here. It is an area within a sanctuary or outside having adequate ecological, faunal, floral, geomorphological, natural and zoological significance. See, every area cannot be termed as national park. For any area to be given status of national park, certain condition has to be met, like it should have adequate ecological, faunal, floral, geomorphological, natural and zoological significance, like it should have huge amount of biodiversity. That's it. In one term, if we try to understand, that could be status as national park in order to protect them. Protect them from what? From protect them from like illegal activities of human being, some natural disasters. So many things can be protected in this national park, and the function is same as it was in wildlife sanctuary, like protecting, propagating or developing wildlife or its environment like that of sanctuary. It's same in case of national parks also. And if we talk about the difference between the sanctuary and national park, so there is only one difference, or you can say one major difference. In case of sanctuary, what we could see that rights of people living in that area could be permitted, and in certain cases it could be abandoned. But in case of national park, no rights allowed. That means any rights of human being would not be allowed in national park. In national park, it has its own rights and regulation, laws and regulation. Any human being are not permitted to hunt or do illegal activities in those areas. And again, it too has a wildlife warden which can regulate or prohibit the permission of anyone entering or moving outside of that area, like cutting trees, and these activities would be governed by that wildlife warden. And apart from this, exploitation of wildlife, forest produce, sanctuary requires recommendation of state board of wildfire removal, etc. That means if any trees, if any plants are required, like for medicinal plants are required, that if any medicinal plant would be present in that particular area only, or if any kind of special trees are required, so to exploit or to use those things, permission would be required from state board of wildlife. Okay, now we'll see a few examples of wildlife sanctuaries and national park which are important for us, that and you should know about them. The first national park is Jim Corbett National Park. So Jim Corbett National Park, there is a very interesting story behind this Jim Corbett National Park. I'm not going to tell you the complete story because it would make the video very large, but I'm telling you just in glimpse. So Jim Corbett National Park, actually Jim Corbett is a name of an person, an English person who was there in India. What he used to hunt in forest of Uttarakhand. So during hunting he killed a tiger, he shooted a tiger, and at that moment something happened to him, and he was very emotional, and because of that very purpose, this Jim Corbett National Park was established during that time. It was established in 1936, before our country was free, or before our country got freedom. And it is India's most beautiful wildlife reserve. Most beautiful wildlife reserve, you can say almost every wildlife reserves are beautiful because national scenery can be seen over there, lots of water bodies, hill station, many things are seen. So almost every wildlife sanctuary and national parks are beautiful. Now if we talk about the location, so it lies in the foothill of Himalayas, which is located in Uttarakhand, and this national park is spread over an area of 1318 square kilometer. Okay, and this is home of very rich ecosystem. Rich ecosystem in the sense we mean that lots of biodiversity, different kind of species are present in this Jim Corbett National Park. and it consists of rolling grassland interspersed with rivers and valleys. So everything would be same over here, what I've already talked, like 600 different species of plants, 650 species of birds and animals, which it includes gharial, elephant, cheetah, sambar, wild boar, king cobra, Indian pangolin, nilgiri, common musk shrew, and flying fox. So lots of different kind of species are present in this national park. Next important national park is Periyar Wildlife Sanctuary. So by the name, I guess you could know that this Periyar Wildlife Sanctuary would be located somewhere in southern part of our country. So yes, this is located in Western Ghat, and the Periyar Wildlife Sanctuary, it is said to be heavens for nature lovers. See, as I said, this heaven, or you can say this beautiful view of this wildlife sanctuary or national park would be common in every protected area, and you can see over here it's given it's heaven for nature lover. And again, it is placed for rarest species, rarest endangered species in the country. I think we have already talked about these Western Ghat and Eastern Ghat in geography, and yeah, in geography only we have talked. So we have seen over there that Western Ghat and Eastern Ghat consist of chains of mountains, and there were lots of river which used to either drain in Arabian Sea, or few rivers drain in Bay of Bengal. So in both the cases, in Western Ghat and Eastern Ghat, we could see it was house or home for huge biodiversity. So it is case in this also. If we talk about specific kind of species which are present over here in Periyar Wildlife Sanctuary, so these are barking deer, dot Indian wildlife dog, deer, mouse, and very rarely a tiger. Tiger is also present in this Periyar Wildlife Sanctuary. Okay. Next is Gir National Park. So this Gir National Park is found in Gujarat, and it covers over area of 1,412 square kilometer. And this is present in peninsular region of Gujarat, India, sorry. And the habitat, which is, sorry, and the habitat of the renowned Asiatic lion. Asiatic lion is the habitat which is only found in this place, okay, in India actually. And it consists of valleys, rivers, dense deciduous forests, swampy grassland. As I said, most of the natural beauty would be common in all the places. But over here, an important factor over here is that this Kamleshwar Dam. Dam, we know what is a dam. Dam is generally made for restricting the flow of river into any direction, and so that the river flow water can be harnessed to produce electricity. For that very purpose, dams are built. So this Kamleshwar Dam provides large water body for marsh crocodiles and reptiles in birds. Okay. Next important national park is Sariska National Park. So this is counted as one of the most frequented wildlife reserve in India, and this is very important, and it is found in Alwar district of Rajasthan. Extension is around 800 square kilometer, and it's not new national park, it dates back to 10th century. See how old this national park is, and there are lots of historical monuments present in this Sariska National Park. And the biosphere of this wildlife sanctuary, it includes rocky landscape, dry deciduous forest, and hilly cliff. Okay. And again, this is very important national park which you should know about. The next is Sundarban National Park. So you might have heard about the Sundarbans, because this is very important for, and it lies in the delta of Bay of Bengal, and it is synonymous, you can say it is synonymous with the wildlife and wildlife sanctuaries in India. And the tigers, Bengal tigers, are conserved in the Sundarbans National Park only. Okay. And its area is around 4264, and this Sundarban National Park has been given status of World Heritage Site by UNESCO. We have already studied about UNESCO and this World Heritage Site. We know already what it is, so I'm not going to tell you again. And if we talk about the species we stay over here, so Royal Bengal tigers, I've already told, jungle cat, flying fox, cheetah, wild boar, and pangolin are found in the Sundarban National Park. Next national important national park is Ranthambore National Park. So this Ranthambore National Park is again found in somewhere in Rajasthan, and it is ranked as one of the largest and most reputed national park in North India wildlife sanctuary. And in earlier times, during earlier times, the Maharajas of the Rajasthan, we know Rajasthan is place of palaces, lots of kings used to stay in Rajasthan, and even now there are certain kings present. So these kings used to go for hunting, and this Ranthambore National Park was a place for their hunting and entertainment. It varies in an area of 1,334 square kilometers. Okay. Now the next point which we are going to study, and I hope this is last topic, it is conservation reserve and community reserve. Okay. So conservative important facts over here, there are only certain important factor, like this plays as a buffer zone between what? Between migration corridor like national park and wildlife sanctuary. So as we said, there was a big area which was defined as wildlife sanctuary, and there was certain area in these wildlife sanctuary which could be termed as national park. It's not necessary that this national park would be there in a wildlife sanctuary, but in case if it is there in between and the wildlife sanctuary, so there needs to be a buffer zone. Buffer zone means the area which is not given any name. So this buffer zone is generally called as conservation reserve and community reserve. Okay. And this difference between this conservation reserve and community reserve is that conservation reserve, they are generally owned by government. All kind of activity which are taking place in conservation reserve are to be governed by government, whereas this community reserve, they are either owned by local people or by private entity. Fine. So these are the generally difference between this conservation reserve and community reserve. And in this community reserve, the administration is done by local people and local agencies like Gram Panchayat. Gram Panchayat and all are responsible for administration of these community reserves. And community reserve is also sometimes used for profit wildlife reserve also, because since they are owned by community, so community can utilize the reserves of or resources of resources present in this area for their own profit or for their own benefits. Okay. And there was some protected area category. It was first introduced in Wildlife Protection Amendment Act in 2002 and Wildlife Protection to 1972. Fine. So let's see if anything else is left. So I hope this ends our video. I have explained everything about protected area network in India. We have seen the types of protected area, and we have seen few important national parks, wildlife sanctuary, and the important significance of this conservation reserve and community reserve. If you have any doubt regarding this topic or any topic till now what we have covered, you can always ask in the comment box. So thank you for watching. See you next video with new topic. Till then, goodbye.